Space is weird and full of wonder. Cosmic phenomena that have strangely augmented the way that we perceive the mechanics of science. You'd think that we'd have to search far and wide to find some of the strangest planetary properties going, but actually our own solar system already harbors some of the weirdest, the most mind-bending cosmic constructs that our tiny ape brains can comprehend. None such other than Jupiter, the fifth planet from our sun, that also happens to be the largest and densest place in our cosmic kaleidoscope. Sun aside, of course. So let's head on down and figure out, what would happen if we fell through Jupiter? Wait, what? Yeah. Hello, Internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if you fell into Jupiter? Roll the clip. For the curious amongst you, that clip was from 1997's Contact, starring Jodie Foster, for several reasons really. The first being that Contact is an awesome movie, but second and most importantly, it's currently impossible to get a visual depiction of what falling into Jupiter would be like, given the fact that it has a habit of eating up and melting down any and every probe that came too close to its baffling surface. Now, that's not to say that Jupiter hasn't been observed at a relatively close distance, as NASA have been sending unmanned probes toward it since the mid-60s, but well, you'll soon understand why the surface of Jupiter is such an overwhelmingly dangerous place for both humans and little robot space probes alike. But first, let's take a look at what's up with Jupiter and why it's such an interesting individual in the planetary lineup of our solar system. First up, Jupiter is an absolutely gigantic gas giant, a planet made up nearly entirely of gaseous and liquid matter, much similar to the likes of Saturn, its lesser and smaller gas giant neighbor. Jupiter has a mass of 1/1000th that of the Sun, but despite that, it comprises a mass that is 2.5 times that of all the other planets in our solar system combined. In short, compared to the Sun, he's small fry, but compared to the solar system, he gobbles them all up like a hungry, hungry gaseous hippo. For the most part, Jupiter remains to be a complete and utter mystery to science, and the real reason why the gas giant is so damn weird is that whilst we previously mentioned that it was made up of both gaseous and liquid matter, that isn't exactly true, because actually, it's made up of neither. Wait, what? Yeah, gas giants as we know them, thanks to their massive size, exhibit immense temperatures and pressures, causing most matter to exist as neither liquid or gas, but instead as a supercritical fluid which shares the properties of both. That's thanks to the wondrous mechanics of critical point thermodynamics, and the explanation of that is way above my pay grade, but just know that it's not gas, it's not liquid, it's both at the same time. Yeah, Jupiter, guys. But it's because of this unique supercritical fluidic property that makes our hypothetical scenario such a bizarre journey. And the quick answer to this question is if you fell into Jupiter without some form of highly advanced, impenetrable spacesuit, your body would be ravaged by staggering amounts of radiation and you'd die before you ever made it roughly 300,000 kilometers away from the surface of its first atmosphere. In fact, the closest that any man-made object has ever gotten to Jupiter's surface was the Galileo probe on September 21st, 2003, when after 8 years of orbiting and surveying Jupiter's many moons of the Jovian system, Galileo's mission was ended when it hurtled into Jupiter's atmosphere at a speed of over 30 miles per second and was never heard from again. What happened to it? Did it succumb to the strange supercritical properties of Jupiter? Was it disintegrated into oblivion? Probably. But guess what? Although the little Galileo probe failed, now it's your turn. And thankfully, for the sake of this hypothetical play-by-play, you get to keep that highly advanced impenetrable spacesuit, which we mentioned previously. Let's say we segued the impossibility of surviving an approach to the gas giant, and you just got conveniently dropped somewhere at the top of Jupiter's upper atmosphere, where actually, the pressure is near enough the same as Earth's surface pressure. Awesome. Here, however, you'd be falling through the planet's white ammonia clouds, where the Sun still remains visible, but unfortunately for you, it's incredibly cold, as in roughly minus 150 degrees Celsius. Down to Jupiter's massive gravity, you'd also be plummeting through the clouds at a rate roughly 2.5 times that of Earth, where the frictional heating and supersonic compression would likely turn you into a flaming ball of oblivion. But let's say that your super spacesuit thankfully comes equipped with a parachute, and you can remain at roughly the same same velocity of 100 meters per second. Well, this spacesuit is really coming in handy, right? Actually though, as long as you could somehow survive the massive velocity that comes with hurtling toward Jupiter without a parachute, you'd probably be pretty comfortable for a while. So you might as well enjoy the view while it lasts. For about 5 minutes, you'd have fallen through endless clouds of ammonia, which actually would be quite relaxing, up until the point where you reach the next level of Jupiter's atmosphere, which is roughly twice the average surface pressure of Earth. During this fall, you'd have most definitely felt some sort of adverse effect, and the cloud system would have changed from the white hue of ammonia to the brownish tint of ammonium hydrosulfide. There's a chance at this point that the liquids in your head could rapidly decompress, so it's probably best that you clear your inner ear and sinuses of any gunk before you depart on this mission. Oh, we probably should have mentioned that at the start. Roughly 10 minutes later, you would have reached the 4 bar pressure level, which is around 4 times the average atmospheric pressure of Earth at sea level. At this point, the temperature would have meandered from mild to freezing, and your thermometer would be reading about minus 40 degrees Celsius. You'd be passing through clouds of water ice, and quickly the vague glow of the sun would have disappeared. Only darkness would remain for the rest of your journey. Thankfully though, your suit would remain intact, which is lucky, given the fact that without it, you'd be breathing lethal levels of nitrogen, and you'd run the risk of suffering from oxygen toxicity. Who knew that oxygen could be lethal at lower pressures? Jupiter. That's who. After about 30 minutes worth of plummeting through atmospheric hell, you'd have fallen to complete and utter darkness as the freezing temperatures give way to immense heat. As you approach the final layers of Jupiter's atmosphere, you'd be blasted with temperatures of over 200 degrees Celsius, where in all likelihood you'd begin to be boiled alive. And if that didn't end your existence, the perplexing properties of Jupiter's interior region await you. Now, it's important to note that science isn't exactly sure of Jupiter's exact composition, but thanks to its immense gravitational properties, we know that its mostly hydrogen atmosphere would actually exhibit as a liquid, which now, as you plunge into it, is at a temperature of several thousand degrees, and only gets worse the higher the pressure becomes. Pressures of 1000 bar, 10,000 bar, until finally, when you reach near Jupiter's core, your body would succumb to the insanely crushing pressure of roughly 2 million bar, and a temperature of around 5000 Kelvin, which is about the temperature of the surface of the sun. It's hot. At this point, hypothetical impenetrable spacesuit aside, your body would nearly entirely be boiled down into good old 2 parts hydrogen and 1 part oxygen, as it slowly sank through an atmospheric sea of molten supercritical hydrogen. It's safe to say that any physical semblance of you would be long, long gone, but thankfully your carbonated husk would have reached equilibrium with the density of Jupiter's sea of molten hydrogen, and your corpse would be entombed forever near the heart of the gas giant. Well, this is a cheery video, isn't it? What did you expect? Falling into any kind of planet is going to end badly, even if it was made of fluffy sunshine and rainbows. On that note, there we have it, the way that science cheerily tells us exactly what would happen if we fell into Jupiter. But you know what they say, it's not the destination, it's the journey that counts. Before we depart from today's video, let's first take a quick look at some of your more entertaining edifications from over the past few days. BatmanFanForever08 says, "I feel like this channel is turning into a scientific version of Mortal Kombat with all the fatalities Earth has gone through in your videos. Anyone else feel the same? Who wants to play a mod of Mortal Kombat with Earth-chan in it? Lol." Yeah, BatmanFanForever08. I'm feeling it, bud. I'm feeling it. Earth needs to do some button mashing some more. Well, on that note, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Cheers for sticking around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, or just Life's Biggest Questions in particular, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe button, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.